He is the director of the world-famous Columbus Zoo, located in world-famous Columbus, Ohio. Please say hello to world-famous Jack Hanna. Jack, come out here.
Come on, Buford.
Hi, Jack.
How are you doing?
What the hell is that?
Come on, Buford. Buford, look here, Buford.
That's a great looking. That's a black bear, isn't it?
It's a black bear.
How old is this bear?
It's Buford.
Buford, hi, Buford. Can I touch the bear?
Oh, yeah, just touch his behind and he'll be all right.
What do you mean touch his behind?
Here's some raisins.
What do you mean touch his behind, Jack? What do you mean by that?
He'll sit up the chair. That's it. Sit down, Buford.
Uh huh. Now
you turn this way.
But where can I touch the animal?
Well, it all depends. You give him a raisin, see how he thinks, or see what he thinks about that.
Do bears have teeth?
Oh yeah.
Oh, they do have teeth.
Yeah, they're this bear's a year old.
Well, here, maybe you better.
Huh? See, he'll respond to you.
Well, I know that, but I mean, I know that these animals can be very, very unpredictable.
That's true.
Now, can I put my hand here?
Right, that'd be good.
Okay.
That's it.
Boy, this is a beautiful animal. You know, I have a dog that looks just about like this. Yeah, this is a good... Now, come on up, Buford. Come on, buddy.
Buford, they told you not to get...
Now, where do we find these guys in their native surroundings?
Well,
what part of the country?
Like the Smoky Mountains.
Yeah.
And, you know, the bear is one of the few carnivores that attacks unprovoked, so when people go on a picnic, you don't want to screw with them.
No, that's right. No. They're very...
You just don't want to mess around with them.
Which contradicts the earlier theory that it was okay to screw with a bear.
No, but that's how a lot of people get in trouble.
Oh, no, people are stupid when they get out there. Yeah, but no, stay clear of them, stay in your car.
Right.
Yeah, because they can go on you. And how old an animal will this get to be? How old will Buford get?
Buford would be about 200 pounds, and he could live to 15 or 20 years old in the zoo.
Yeah, he's a beautiful guy.
They usually hibernate, but I don't know. He woke up and not hibernating.
No, well, how come he isn't hibernating? That's a good point.
At the zoo, he woke up about 4 weeks ago. And then back to sleep, so I decided to bring him. But they told me I could bring him.
You're not the real director of the zoo.
No, I am, too.
What have you done with Jack Hanna?
No, I'm the director of the zoo. That's a big zoo.
But bears hibernate in the winter.
I know, but the black bear just kind of sleeps a little bit, and he didn't go to sleep. Hibernation's difficult.
Yeah, well, of course.
It's not like
that. No. Believe me, we couldn't expect that out of you, Jack. You're just the director.
I know.
Well, this is a great-looking guy here. Now
I've got another guy.
What do they eat besides chocolate-covered raisins?
No, these are yogurt-covered.
Oh, yogurt-covered.
I don't want anybody to think I'm feeding candy.
Yeah, okay. Well, now we got to get all these other animals out here.
Yeah, but they eat, like, vegetables and meat and stuff.
Okay.
And my sloth. I want to show you the sloth. Okay. You won't believe it.
Should we leave Buford right here?
No, come on, Buford, because he doesn't like the sloth.
All right, bye, Buford. Bye-bye. Nice seeing you. And he weighs, what, about 100 pounds?
Oh, yeah. Come on, Buford, down here, buddy.
Oh, this will be good.
You can't make it.
Whoa!
Oh, no!
Buford, down here,
watch, you got the sloth.
Oh, shoot. Buford, put the sloth over here, bud.
Just maybe we get Buford out and then, bring him right over here next to the bear. That's right.
Get the bear.
Get the bear. There we go. Okay.
Come on, Buford. I don't want the sloth up there.
All right. Bye-bye, Buford. Bye-bye.
I don't want the sloth up.
Okay.
Fred.
Now, you got some...
I don't want to hurt.
Now, what's the matter, Jack?
Now that the sloth wasn't supposed to get off his tree, we built him this habitat.
And he's not supposed to get off that, is he?
No.
No, but he did, didn't he?
Yeah.
What, now, was this one hibernating as well?
No, this animal here...
Oh, you know, he shouldn't... This thing may go off. This is a paper shredder. Don't let him get his...
Brad, turn it off. Turn it off.
I don't know how to turn it off.
I'm serious.
Get his claw out of there.
Brad, turn the thing off. Just unplug it.
I unplug it. All right, relax. Will you get a hold of yourself?
I am.
See, it's all right. I unplugged it. Okay.
This is
all right. Now, here, you get this one out of here, all right?
No.
I'm taking over the damn zoo, all right?
This thing just...
I know. It's been a tough day. You brought him all the way up here from Columbus.
Yeah,
it's a sloth. Sloth is a marsupial, isn't it?
Red? It's not really... No, it's not a marsupial. It's not a marsupial. I know that. It's not a marsupial because it doesn't have a pouch.
It's not born in a pouch?
No. Okay, and the neat thing about a sloth is... that it spends its life on one limb sometimes in a tree, its whole life. And it's only mammal that defecates about once every 3 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And it goes down the tree to the same spot, and it takes him about 2 weeks to get back up, and then right away he's got to come back down again.
Huh. So it has a really, really slow metabolism.
It takes about 15 feet, about 20 minutes to move.
Yeah. And what do they do for fun? I mean, what is their...
Well, a lot of times they don't do much, because when I've seen them in South America, they have green stuff all over them, like algae and everything, because they don't move very fast. And it's incredible, because a lot of them live in the trees, and you hardly even know he's up there. It looks like a bird's nest.
Have you ever been to South America?
I was near there. I was there. I was in Central America. I was there once.
All right, yeah. And the sloth, what does he eat?
At the zoo, eats. We put sweet potatoes in the microwave. But in the wild, he eats.
In the wild, they have to put them in a regular oven, don't they?
You know, in the zoo, or in the wild, he eats like leaves and stuff.
All right, get another animal, Jack. Okay. We want to get all of these guys in here because every time you come up here, you fly all of these up.
Oh, they had to drive because
drove all of them. It's a lot of work to get these animals ready.
This is one of my favorites. I bet nobody knows what that is.
That's something out of your wife's closet.
Can you believe that's an angora rabbit?
Is that right?
Yeah, look at that. Isn't that beautiful?
That's amazing. Now, but this is not the source of angora wool, is it? That would be goats, I think, is it?
Right. And but our lady said she had an angora rabbit, but they don't kill them to get the wool. They just shear them.
Oh, I see.
They
don't have to but they do shear rabbits.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Right. Isn't that something, though?
That's a beauty.
I love this rabbit.
All right, we have to take a commercial break.
It's from Ohio, by the way.
That's an Ohio rabbit?
Yeah, because you're going to ask me where it's from. It's from Ohio. I know where that thing's from.
Okay, good. So you've been reading up. That's a beautiful looking owl. What kind is that?
It's a great horned owl.
Uh-huh.
And
so named because of the tufts up here, right?
Tufts up there.
Now those aren't his ears, though, are they?
No, he's got good hearing, though. I don't know where the ears are. They're somewhere behind the eyes. he's got good hearing.
If you had to guess, though, where would you say the ears are?
I'd say they're probably
somewhere above the neck, maybe. Somewhere in there. Yeah.
Somewhere in there. But you know, an owl doesn't have eye muscles in his eyes, so I don't know if he'll do that. I don't want him to twist his head all the way off. But look back here at David. Look over here.
What's the owl's name? Do you have a name for the owl?
Hootie. I just call him Hootie.
Try not to get too technical here, Jack, will you? No. Hootie. But because of the lack of eye muscles, the head has to do the work for the eyes.
Has to move the whole head.
And it will swivel 300...
All the way around.
But then it has to go back around, right?
Exactly.
It doesn't continue.
He just twists his neck off.
Now, those are beautiful. Why are his eyes so yellow in there? What causes... Does that color ever change?
Not really, but his pupils for nocturnal vision, because he really should be asleep right now. He didn't wake up about midnight, so he should be asleep right
now. So his pupils are actually, when they're dilated, about the size of a quarter, aren't they, when they're wide open?
Just huge. And plus, those claws, the talons there, you can see, they can exert about 1,000 pounds of pressure when he gets excited. So that's why we...
And this thing feeds on rodents?
Rodents. And this one here could even attack a real large rabbit. I mean, they'll attack something even lot bigger than they are.
Yeah.
Because they catch them at nighttime and go swooping out.
They're
the tree.
Amazing animals, aren't they?
Oh, yeah, they really are.
Okay.
I got another bird here.
And we find these all over the country.
They're all over. But they're birds, they're predators, and in most states, you're not allowed to hunt the owl.
Yeah.
Because they help with mice.
Well, who would be hunting owls anyway? What kind of dinner is
farmers,
owl meat? Who eats owl meat?
They don't eat the owls. The owl eats the chickens.
Oh, I see. They keep it from going after the chickens. Yeah, all right.
I got my bird here, my crane here somewhere.
Now, let's see what else we have, Jack.
Well, I do have a crane. I know that. The owl's supposed to...
Well, do you want me to do something about...
Yeah, we got a... Oopsie daisy. That's all right. We got it. There we go. There you go.
Whoa.
Here we go.
Oh.
Now, this right here, this is a neat animal here.
This again.
This is a sandhill...
This is a what?
Sorry,
Jack?
I guess this is a sandhill crane, and this thing, you can see his legs there?
Yep.
Look at that.
This?
Yeah, that's a radio transmitter on his leg, and then the other one is like where he was born, when he was born, all those red tags there.
Oh, so you're about ready to release
him, and he'll go down to...
Do they fly?
Oh, he's nice.
No, but I mean when you release him, will he fly?
Oh, yeah, He's just a baby crane.
Uh-huh.
He gets to be about this big.
Uh-huh.
And they got him in Michigan.
Now, how far do you think this will migrate when he goes?
Oh, a long way. He'll go down to probably Texas.
He'll go from Columbus to Texas?
Well, actually, he came from Michigan, and then the Wildlife Department told me to take care of him or the zoo.
Uh-huh.
And then we'll take him back to Michigan when everybody goes back south again in the winter.
Yeah. Oh, I see.
He can't go right now.
So you don't just take him out to I-70 and turn him loose?
Oh, no, can't do that.
Yeah.
No, he has to go with the group and follow his way down. That way, they'll see you can track him with all that.
Well, to see one of these things in flight must be a really impressive display.
Oh, you can imagine when he gets real big.
Yeah. And again, these eat what?
Wow. They eat fish.
They're fishermen, aren't they?
Yeah, and I was going to bring a fish.
Now, we got one more animal.
Right, we got one more.
We're going to get them all in here.
Oh, we're going to get them all in.
All right, can you leave the crane out for this?
Oh, he's fine, yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Boy, oh, boy, look at this guy. What is this? Oh, brother. Boy, this is a beautiful looking cat. What is that?
This is Witchy.
Hi, Witchy. How are you? Can I touch
you? Oh, yeah. This is a mountain lion.
Oh, brother.
Or a cougar. This is just a baby.
How old is Witchy?
A baby cougar. Witchy's about 6 months now.
Where did you get Witchy?
I think he just...
Whoa!
Whoa!
He just a little noise.
You said it's a cougar?
Mm-hmm.
And where did you get Witchy?
Oh, Witchy was born in Ohio.
Uh-huh.
At the zoo. And this cougar, oh, he's like... Oh. He just wants to jump around. He's fine.
Yeah, that's right. Sure. And how big will this cougar get? Oh, what is a cougar, exactly?
All right, a cougar is like a mountain lion. A cougar, you're referring to all those types mm-hmm. of things. And they're still from North America.
Well, we still have them. Would you find them in the Midwest, or would be none in the woods around Columbus, or would there?
Oh, no. They better not be in Columbus. But
where would
still
you find them?
Probably out in Colorado, some places like that. But aren't they gorgeous?
Yeah.
Do
we have a lot of these animals in the wild, Jack?
Pretty many, because the habitat for the cougar... He can adjust to most habitats, and so that's why he hasn't become extinct like a lot of the wolves.
And they're protected. People can't hunt these guys.
Oh no, you're not supposed to.
Yeah,
no.
yeah. Boy, that's a beautiful animal.
Pretty.
And what does the cougar feed on?
He eats
come
meat.
Here, Witchy.
Witchy,
eats what?
Eats
what?
He's meat.
A meat eater. A carnivore.
Carnivore. Yeah, that's right. Carnivore.
Come on, Witchy. Come here. Now, is the crane that got upset?
I don't think a crane. I just think
I think this crane is ceramic. I think.
No, I don't.
I think. I think Jack had this crane on his front yard and just decided to throw out the truck and bring it up here.
Why don't they come and get this?
Hi, Witchy. Okay, we got one more or are we done?
Yeah, I got one more. I just didn't want to eat my rabbit.
No, we don't. Okay, we got one more.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Okay, well, now don't turn him loose on me, Jack. Here. You want me to take that?
Yeah. Well, somebody come out here. I don't want him to attack
you. You know, if you could get here for rehearsal, Jack, it'd be a big help to us. Okay, it's Jack Hanna, folks, from the Columbus
an
Zoo. And a possum. Now, this is a marsupial.
Oh, yeah. Look at this. You won't believe this. I can show everybody home. I'm not hurting you. I want to show everybody home this pouch. You can look here at the camera. Look at this big. Look at this hole here. You put 17 babies. I don't know where the camera. See, look at this. Phil, just stick your finger.
No, I'm not going to. This is an old party trick. I've heard this before.
No, it's not. This is your pouch.
Yeah, I know. Okay, Jack. All right. We'll be right back. Thanks, Jack.